Hi there. Since many of you asked about how I flush Rochelle out every day through her Port-A-Cath system, I figured I'd make a short video on just how to do the proper restraining bunrito for it. So I have this setup right here, which is just a simple tuberculin needle on a line, just an IV line. I have this side tied off, and I have it already back flushed out. I use a 22 gauge for a feeder off of just a standard monoject tube. I put about 5 milliliters in there of 10% gentamicin, 0.9 nit NaCl flush. Anyway, so I have that in there. It's already been prepped. Everything's good. The lure lock's already secured. So the first thing you have to do when you're already ready with all this is you have to find a rabbit somewhere. And you can call, or you can get treats, or you can just try to find one lying around. And here's a bunny. Well, hello there. Would you like to get your nose flushed out? Okay. So you find a rabbit, and you put the rabbit right here. Now, I do a little bit different bunrito than a lot of people do. I don't suggest you do this type of bunrito every time, but this type of bunrito is actually, I think, the most effective for this type of restraint, although it's a little brutal, and I wouldn't do it every time, and I'd only do it under very, very close supervision. I like to wrap over the, she knows what this is. You want to make sure they're nice and flat. You want to fold over the bunrito, a first fold here, all the way out, to restrain the front paws. This is so important. While I'm doing this, notice how I have pressure on the scapular halves here, on this part of the scapular cervical scapular spine here. Tuck it in, just like that. Don't put pressure directly on the spine, but put pressure on the scapular halves, a little bit. Once you've done this, you've kind of immobilized the feet, or at least isolated the feet from the cervical area. Then you want to wrap with the ears down, wrap over, all the way over on both sides, and tuck in from the bottom up, like that. Remember, pressure on the scapular halves. Okay, now once that part of the bunrito is done, over the other side, on both halves. Okay, here, here. Okay, now they can still get out of this, so you want to make sure to hold like that, right, on both sides. I'm putting a little pressure on both sides here, and I'm pulling down. And she can still get out of this, so I have to make sure to hold her like this, and also put a little pressure right on the bottom, usually to the left, not right on the spine. Okay, she knows it's coming. She knows this is going to be a little painful. So I tend to take a little bit of this, and I tend to just flush a teen little bit out first, like that. Put the needle back up on the bed, make sure it's not going into the, when you put it down, you wanna make sure it doesn't poke into the bed to not, you don't wanna dull the bevel before poking. Okay, everything looks good. I have a little bit of the area flushed. I've already washed my hands about 5 times before this. Okay. Everything looks good. You search for the port, which is right here. The port, center of the port is a little gooey. Now, my technique is usually to put this off to the side. Search for the port. And this is going to hurt for both of us. She's going to hate this. I'm going to hate doing it to her. But it's going to have to get done. And we're in. Once you're in, flush. Now nice and slow, to get a drain. Once it's done, out quickly, a little bit on the edge, rub it in, and then gently put the pressure off. I tend to put her down on the ground after this just so she can get her bearings. And that is how you do a proper genomycin flush with a Port-A-Cath on a rabbit.